Right now, all of our eggs are in one basket, and the basket's called Earth. We can't stay in this solar system forever. It's just a fact. So if we do stay here, we would essentially, you know, the sun would essentially engulf the inner planets. And even if we've achieved perfect world peace and there's no hunger, there's no poverty, there's no disease, it'll all be gone if we're still here. So some of the first missions to Mars, obviously we have multiple satellites already in orbit, and so some of the first missions are really planned for within the next 15 years, but there are active and long-term plans in NASA to have people, you know, colonies there, living there, whether it's either asteroids, moons, or potentially Mars. You know, the timeline goes up to 200 or 300 years out is when we've started to begin some of that work of actually not just sending exploratory missions, but people are actually living there. And I think this is not only sort of what is the natural next step of really human evolution and exploration, but I would even argue as our duty as a species, because we're the only species that has an awareness of extinction. So I think that gives us the responsibility to preserve not only our species, but actually all species. But if you keep going further out, eventually you go to Mars, you go to other solar systems, it's really the question just begs the question back on itself. It's like, well, you can't keep going and going and going. At the end of the time, eventually the universe will either keep expanding, and so it will be too far apart, or it may collapse back in on itself. And so I think there, the last question of my long-term plan for the laboratory is, which of course we'll all be long dead for, but do we prevent the universe from collapsing back in on itself in the hopes that life will arise anew, or do we actually use our ingenuity and technological acumen to prevent the universe from collapsing? And at that point, maybe we'd be controlling gravity. I think we would have to probably prevent it and maybe carve out a small area of the universe that wouldn't collapse or would somehow survive, which we have no idea how that's going to happen. But I think the ethical question we can think about today is how much and to what degree do we literally alter the universe to preserve ourselves? And I think life and gravity are the only two things that prevent expansion of matter in the universe, and so I think, and sort of decrease entropy, and so I think we have a responsibility to try and maybe keep ourselves alive. So I think not only maybe should we keep ourselves alive even at the end of the universe, but that we may have no choice, because I think that's what we usually do as a species.